Today we'll start with aldehydes and ketones. These are the organic compounds which are containing carbonyl group. Aldehyde will be represented as this RCHO, where R can be the alkyl group or aryl group. And ketones you are representing as RCR-O. Now this RR- can be same or different, and they can be alkyl or aryl groups. Let us talk about the nomenclature. One is the common system, as you all know, and second one is the IUPAC system. Now in IUPAC system, the longest chain which is containing the CHO group in case of aldehyde, it will be identified, and total number of carbon atom in this chain is counted, and aldehyde will be named as the derivative of the corresponding hydrocarbon. The end E of the hydrocarbon will be replaced by Al. Now if you see this example, in this case numbering you will start from here. Since preference is given to the functional group, so this will be 2-methyl and 4 carbons are there, so butanol. Now in ketones, the suffix E of the hydrocarbon, it will be converted into ON. We will see this example. In this numbering, we will start from here so that the functional group gets the lowest number, and this will be 3-methyl pentane 2-ON. Now this one is butane 1,4. Since two aldehyde groups are there, so it will be diL. This is a ketonic group and with 5 carbon, so it will be pentane and 3-ON. This one will be methanol. This is 2 with 2 carbon, so it will be ethanol. With 3 carbon, it will be propanol, and this will be benzaldehyde, which is a common name, otherwise it is benzene carbaryl aldehyde. This generally we name as formaldehyde, this one as acetaldehyde, this one as acetone. Now let us come to the preparation of aldehydes. Now they can be prepared from acid chloride. You can see here acid chloride is taken. Now hydrogen gas will be passed through the hot solution of acid chloride in presence of xylene in xylene solution using palladium and barium sulfate as a catalyst. So you'll be getting aldehyde and HCl. Now here I have taken example of acetyl chloride. I have taken, so I'm treating it with the hot gas, hydrogen gas through the hot solution of acetyl chloride in xylene using palladium and barium sulfate as a catalyst. I am getting acetaldehyde and HCl. Since this is with benzoyl chloride I am taking, so it will give you benzaldehyde and HCl. Now let us talk about the ketones. In this case I'm taking benzene and acid chloride in presence of anhydrous AlCl3. It will give you ketone, as you can see here, plus HCl. So here I have taken an example of preparation of benzophenone. You can see here. Now in this case benzene is taken and it is treated with benzoyl chloride in presence of anhydrous AlCl3, so you are getting a diphenyl ketone, that is benzophenone plus HCl. So this is one of the method by which we can prepare. Second preparation is from cyanide, that is alkyl cyanide you will take, which on reduction with the stannous chloride and HCl, that will give you the corresponding aldehyde. Now during that process, an intermediate is formed, that is aldehyde, and that is highly unstable, and immediately it will react to give you the product. Now in this case I have taken an example in which I am reducing it by Stefan's process, it is known as. So you can see here in between an intermediate is formed which is highly unstable, that in presence of water will give you what is known as acetaldehyde. So same is the case with aromatic compounds. Here I have taken benzonitrile and or what is also known as phenyl cyanide, that in presence of stannous chloride at Cl and water will give you benzaldehyde. This nitrile, they react with Grignard reagent also, and they can give you what is known as the ketone. So from nitriles you can prepare aldehyde as well as the ketones. Now let us talk about the physical properties of aldehyde and ketones. Formaldehyde is gas at room temperature, whereas the other members of aldehyde family and ketones, they are liquid or solids. Now as you know that carbonyl group, it is polar in nature and they are held by dipole-dipole forces of attraction. So you can see that carbonyl, this is polar in nature, so carbonyl compounds, they have lower boiling point than alcohols, because alcohol, it is having hydrogen bonding. So you can say if in this case in ortho position there is possibility of hydrogen bonding, that will reduce the size of the molecule, so boiling point is lowered. As we all know that boiling point, it depends on the type of the bonding which is present. Now let us talk about the reactions. This is the addition of HCl. Since carbonyl, it is polar in nature, so it will undergo nucleophilic addition reaction. Since the bond from here will shift here, this will become negative, this is positive, so there is a site for nucleophilic attack. So with HCN, you can see this being positive, CN, it will attach to carbon, and this being negative, H will attach to the oxygen. So if you do the comparison among aldehyde and ketones, aldehydes, they are more reactive towards nucleophilic substitution, because in case of aldehyde there is less inductive effect and less steric hindrance. So this is an example of aldehyde and this is an example of ketone. Here one alkyl group is present, so inductive effect is due to this alkyl group, whereas in ketones two alkyl groups are present, so there will be more inductive effect, there will be more steric hindrance, thus decreasing its reactivity. So when you compare the aromatic and aliphatic aldehydes, the aromatic, they have less reactivity due towards the nucleophilic addition reaction. That is because of the charge of the carbonyl cation, which is dispersed over the benzene ring. You can see it here, this positive charge that is being dispersed over the benzene ring. If we see the reactivity order among this, ethanol will be more reactive, then propanol, then propanone and butanone, because as you go this side, the number of alkyl group, they are increasing, thus decreasing its reactivity. And among this, para-nitroaldehyde will be more reactive, then benzaldehyde, then para-tolualdehyde and acetophenone. Again, in this also, the reactivity is depending on the nature of whether electron withdrawing group is present or electron donating group is present. So as a whole, if you see carbonyl group, you are reacting with HCN, you will get what is known as the cyanohydrene. And if you see the mechanism, so this bond will shift here, this will become negative, this will become positive. So first will nucleophile will attack and then the electrophile will attack. So there is a nucleophilic addition in this case. Let us see the addition of alcohol. Now in acetone, when alcohol is added, this part will become OC2H5 and H plus, and this bond will shift here, this will become negative and this positive. So this OC2H5 will attack carbon and hydrogen will attack oxygen. So you will get this compound, which on further treatment will give you diethyl derivative. Similarly, you can see this with aldehyde also. When you treat aldehyde with ethanol in presence of HCl, you are getting diethyl acetyl of benzaldehyde. Next is the addition of sodium bisulfite. CO reacting with NaH SO3. So you will be getting what is known as a bisulfite compound. So this is with the acetone, we are getting acetone bisulfite, and this is with benzaldehyde, you will be getting benzaldehyde bisulfite. Now let us come to the mechanism, how actually this is occurring. Attack of bisulfite ions will take place followed by shifting of hydrogen to the carbonyl oxygen. So first this will shift here, this will be negative, this will become positive, so SO3H will attack carbon, and then will be the rearrangement. This hydrogen will move, leaving the electron, and then it will be shifting here. This being negative will take the sodium. So you will get this bisulfite compound. Now let us talk about the addition of ammonia derivative, NH2G. Now this can be hydroxylamine, it can be hydrazine, or it can be phenyl hydrazine and semi-carbazide. They all react with carbonyl compound to give you, if hydroxylamine is there, you will get oxime. You can get hydrazone with hydrazine. You will get phenyl hydrazone with phenyl hydrazine, and so on. So what is actually happening? This carbonyl compound is reacting with this derivative, and it is giving you this compound. This is a type of rearrangement. Now let us see here, water will be eliminated during the process. Now let us see here, carbonyl compound reacting with hydroxylamine. So water will be eliminated, and what is left is the oxime. With hydrazine, again water will be eliminated, you are left with hydrazone. Same is the case with phenyl hydrazine, you will get phenyl hydrazone. So during that process, water will be eliminated and you will get the corresponding compound. Now let us understand the mechanism. This reaction takes place in four steps. First will be the attack of proton, followed by the nucleophilic attack, then loss of proton, and then finally the loss of water molecule. So this is the step one in which the proton, it is attacking. So this bond will shift here, this will be negative, this positive, so proton will attack. So this is the first step. Second step now will be the nucleophilic attack. That is the ammonia derivative in which hydrogen is nitrogen is having a lone pair of electron. It will attack as a nucleophile here and attach itself to the carbonyl carbon, which will result in a positive charge on the nitrogen atom. So you can see here this lone pair of electrons over the nitrogen, they will act as a nucleophile. So they are attacking here. So finally they are attaching itself to the carbonyl carbon atom, so that is resulting in a positive charge on the nitrogen atom. In step 3 there will be loss of proton, because whatever this is formed is highly unstable, so it loses a proton, so it will lose one proton and you will get this compound. Finally the product form in the step 3, it will lose a water molecule to give you the product. So water molecule will be lost, OH from here, H from here. So this bond will shift here, this bond will break, and finally you will get the product. So let us do this with the aldehyde. So first will be the attack of proton, resulting the formation of this.
Second will be the attack of nucleophile over it. It will be attached to the carbonyl carbon and you will get a compound like this. Third one is the removal of proton. So this is how the proton, it is removed, one of the proton from here. It will be removing and you will get a compound like this. And finally is the loss of water molecule that results in the formation of this derivative. Let us study the test of distinction between aldehydes and ketones. First one being the Tollens reagent or silver mirror test. Tollens reagent is nothing but monical silver nitrate solution. So aldehyde, when react with Tollens reagent, it will give you a silver mirror. While ketone, when react with Tollens reagent, there will be no such reaction. So you can distinguish between aldehyde and ketones. Second is the Phalling solution test. Phalling's reagent is taken, both Phalling A and B. Phalling A is aqueous copper sulfate and Phalling B is alkaline sodium potassium tartarate. So aldehyde, when react with the Phalling A and B solution, it will give you a red brown precipitate of cuprous oxide, whereas no such reaction it occurs in the ketones. Next one is the iodoform test. That is the reaction with sodium hypoiodide, and that is used for distinction of CH3CO group is present or not. You will be getting a yellow precipitate with it. So these are the tests which are used to distinguish between aldehyde and ketones. Now let us talk about the aldol condensation. It is a condensation reaction in which the carbonyl groups, you can see here, carbonyl group, two carbonyl groups I have taken, which are having alpha hydrogen atom. Alpha means with respect to functional group, the first carbon which is having the hydrogen will be the alpha hydrogen. It react in presence of a base to give you aldol. Why we call aldol? Because it is having ald group, aldehyde group and ol group, alcohol group. So let us see what mechanism is going on. First will be the formation of carbonyl, in which I have taken the first aldehyde and reacting it with the base. So the alpha hydrogen from this aldehyde, it will be abstracted by the base, and when this hydrogen moves, it is positive, so this bond will shift here, this will be negative, so you will get minus CH2CHO, that is carbanion. This carbanion is resonance stabilized, you can see here. Now this carbanion, it will be attacking the second aldehyde which we have taken. So let us see the mechanism. So second aldehyde is this carbanion, it is, in this case it is acting as a nucleophile. So this bond shifts here, this O will become negative, carbon will become positive, so this can attach here, resulting in the formation of this product. Third will be the proton abstraction from water. Now this compound will abstract proton from water, resulting in the formation of aldol. Now aldol condensation can be cross condensation also. You can see here HCHO, that is formaldehyde, and CH3CHO, acetaldehyde, they both are reacting, resulting in the formation of an aldol. Or formaldehyde reacting with acetone, resulting in a formation of aldehyde. So there can be cross aldol condensation also. Next, let us talk about the Cannizzaro reaction. It is named after the scientist. In this alpha aldehydes which are not having alpha hydrogen, like formaldehyde, benzaldehyde, they will undergo self oxidation and reduction. These aldehydes, they don't have alpha hydrogen, so they will react in presence of NaOH to give you carboxylic acid and alcohol. So in this case, two aldehydes with no alpha hydrogen I have taken, formaldehyde and benzaldehyde, and that is giving you an alcohol and acid derivative. Now let us come to the mechanism. In this first nucleophilic attack will be taking place. So let us take the first molecule, C6H5CHO, reacting as OH, reacting with OH. Now in this case, OH is acting as a nucleophile. In aldol condensation, OH was acting as a base. So this is the difference between the two. So this shift here, this will become negative, this positive, so OH can attack carbon. So you are getting this compound. In this, the second step is hydride transfer. In aldol, first step was hydride transfer and second was nucleophilic attack. In this, first is nucleophilic attack and second is the hydride transfer. Now you can see here, this is reacting with the second aldehyde molecule. So what is happening, this is shifting here, this will become negative, this positive, so this negative charge is shifting here and carbon becomes unstable, so it will shift this pair of electron to hydrogen. Hydrogen become negative, so it can shift here to the positive side. So what I am getting is C6H5COOH. And second is C6H5COH. Now third step is common in aldol as well as Cannizzaro reaction, that is they will abstract hydrogen from water, resulting in the formation of alcohol. So you are getting an acid and alcohol. Now Cannizzaro reaction can also be a cross Cannizzaro reaction. For example, the formaldehyde reacting with the benzaldehyde, giving the corresponding alcohol and acid. Now let us talk about the Wittig reaction. This reaction takes place between aldehyde and ketones or ketones with the methylene triphenyl phosphorane yield, resulting in the formation of corresponding alkene. Now first we should know how this is formed. This is formed by a reaction of triphenyl phosphorus with methyl iodide, resulting in the formation of an intermediate that in presence of base will give you this methylene triphenyl phosphorane. Now let us see that what actually is going on with acetone. I have taken ethylidene triphenyl phosphorane and that is giving you the corresponding alkene. Let us talk about the mechanism which is going on. So the reaction, it occurs in two steps. First will be the attack by this yield and the second will be the nucleophilic attack. So first will be the formation of a carbonyl, because the phosphorus yield, it act as a resonance hybrid of two structures. So this bond will shift here, this will become negative, this become positive, so you are getting a carbonyl. This carbonyl thus formed will attack the carbonyl cation and you will get an intermediate. So this bond will shift here, this will become negative, this will become positive, so this can attack here. So that results in a formation of betaine. Now in this rearrangement will occur, you can see here, this bond is shifting here, that results in formation of C double bond C R R dash, and this bond is shifting here, so that results in the formation of C6H5 thrice PO. So this is how the Wittig reaction takes place.